Institute is equipping effective advocates for family stability and love, both at home and in the public square. You can be better informed, more motivated, and more effective. Subscribe to our fact-filled newsletter, participate in our book clubs, attend a workshop, and of course, you're tuned into our podcasts. Dr. J is speaking with John Harper on Relevant Radio's Morning Air about 101 Tips for a Happier Marriage, one of the books she co-authored with Betsy Kerrigus, and Ruth Institute's Go to Confession campaign running in Lake Charles, Louisiana during Lent.
Perhaps one of your Lenten goals is to strengthen your marriage, or as Father Rocky was mentioning yesterday, is to give up maybe a sharper tongue or a little sarcasm or those snarky comments that, you know, we may think is witty at the moment, but does a lot of damage to someone else. And perhaps you're doing that really in your own marriage and your conversation with your wife or your husband. Dr. Jennifer Rohrbach-Morse is joining us this morning. And as we begin our Lenten journey, if you want to strengthen your marriage over the next 40 days, she's got some tips for a happier marriage. Dr. Jennifer, welcome back.
Well, thanks for having me on. I'm excited.
As we begin our Lenten journey, it's kind of a reset for New Year's. We make New Year's resolutions in our secular lives, and maybe some of those have some spiritual overtones as well. And perhaps some of our Relevant Radio listeners said, okay, I'm going to be a little more civil. I'm going to have some more patience. I'm going to show some more attention to my husband, to my wife in the new year. And they're renewing that here on this Ash Wednesday. And I'm sure that's one of your tips to a happier marriage, is just that simple attention to each other, because we hear from so many married couples, as I'm sure you do, Dr. Jennifer, where they get into a routine with the kids, with the job, with life, that they forget about spending time with each other.
Well, that's very true. And you know, we compiled a book of 101 tips for a happier marriage with the idea that nobody is ultimately happy, but everybody can be happier, you know, so wherever you are in your married life, there's always something you can do that will make things better between you and your spouse. And I don't care whether you're male or female, whether you've been married 5 minutes, you've been married 50 years, you know, there's always things you can do to love more and be more present to your spouse. And that's what we try to do with 101 Tips for a Happier Marriage.
And we'll put the link to that book up on our Morning Air Facebook page so you can get it as well. Dr. Jennifer Rohrbach-Morse joining us with the tips to a happier marriage, 101 tips to a happier marriage in the book. We're looking at some of the tips this morning on Morning Air on Relevant Radio and the Relevant Radio app. In your experience as the founder of the Ruth Institute, which is focused on keeping the family together, protecting the rights of children, and keeping marriages strong, is there one recurring theme that you hear when couples say, you know, I got your book, Dr. Jennifer, or we spent time together, Dr. Jennifer, and you were absolutely right. In our marriage, we were missing. What is that?
Well, you know, one of the most popular sections of our little book is a chapter called Winning is for Losers. And what we mean by winning is for losers is that we think that we have to win every argument, you know, and the world teaches us that in order to stand up for ourselves and be tough and strong and have good self-esteem, you know, by golly, we have to prevail in every argument. And the fact is, most of the things we get upset about are trivial things, you know, like what we're going to have for dinner and, you know, what color the curtains are going to be and, you know, what kind of car we're going to buy and, you know, just all kinds of things like that. And, you know, the fact is, it's very, very seldom that anybody's eternal salvation or earthly life depends on the outcome of any of those decisions. And so if you're the kind of person who has to win every argument, I'm telling you right now, you are a loser, okay? And that's not a sign of strength. It's a sign of weakness. It's a sign of not being sure of yourself, of not being confident. Because if you're really confident, especially in your faith life, you know, you can say, you know what, I'm going to let my husband have his way here. It's not that big of a deal. Honey, let's do it your way, you know. And over time, you know, when I first started doing that, I tell you, I wasn't feeling it. It was a job to make myself do that. But over time, it's like we have built so much more trust that we really can let go of small decisions and let the other person have their way, and it doesn't feel like a sacrifice anymore. It just feels like, okay, this is the way we relate to each other. And so over time, instead of us trusting it, you know, it's like a big deal to trust him with how much salt I'm going to put on the food, you know. that's the thing people quarrel about. And now, when we moved recently, he bought a car for our family. I didn't even see it. I didn't even drive it. I knew he was going to pick out a fine car. I said, honey, you handle it. When we moved here to Louisiana, I picked out a house. He didn't even see it. And our young friends were like, you let her buy a house without even seeing this house, you know? And my husband said, I knew it would be fine. I knew I would love it. And that's because in his mind, we had trained each other, you know, to love what the other person chooses. And so therefore we built trust over time. But anyway, I'm rambling, but I think people can get the idea there that wherever you are in this process, just let it go. That can be your thing for Lent.
That is absolutely beautiful, Dr. Jennifer, because I'm thinking as you described it, as you started telling that story, both you and your husband have gotten to this level of forgiveness and trust. That's such a great witness to so many couples. Talk about tips for a happier marriage. There are two primary ones right there, number one, number two.
Yeah. What were they? Winning is for losers.
Forgiveness and trust. Yeah, there you go.
Yeah.
There you go.
Yeah, that's right.
Dr. Jennifer Roback Morris this morning here with Tips to a Happier Marriage. The book is 101 Tips for a Happier Marriage. We've got the link up on our Morning Air Facebook page. Do you go to confession with your husband? Have you done that as a family?
And talk about
the power of doing that together as a couple.
Well, you know what? My husband's not Catholic. I just think St. Monica over here, that I've been praying for this man's conversion for a long time. But I personally, I go to confession once a week. I'm blessed to be in a parish where they have confession a half hour before every Mass. I go to daily Mass 5 days a week. One day or another, I can make it in there before 6:30 in the morning Mass. So that's been a huge blessing to my spiritual life to be able to go in there because you start to uncover the little stuff, you know. I used to think, you know, when the saints would say, when Saint Teresa of Avila or somebody would say, oh my gosh, I'm such a terrible sinner. And I would think, oh, come on, girl, you are not such a terrible sinner. What are you talking about, you know? But when you peel away the big stuff and you peel away more and more stuff, you see down there what that bedrock of selfishness looks like and that bedrock of resistance to God, you know. That's the core of it all, and that's what you have to work on a daily basis. You know that the ways in which we're resisting love, the ways in which we're hanging on to our view of how things should be, and so on. So I if you're in a Catholic marriage, I definitely recommend that you go to confession as a family. Absolutely, it's a great blessing.
Dr. Morris, you mentioned how culture wants us to win every argument. It wants us to be puffed up and have a lot of pride in our attitude. Talk a little about the necessity and the joy in being humble toward one another in our marriages.
Well, you know what? Humility, people think that humility is like being a doormat. And that's not really true. Being humble is about being realistic. Right? It's about facing reality. And in fact, we have this right on the front of our book, in the front page, you know, before you even get into the chapters. The very first thing we have there is, God is God. You are not. Your spouse is not. You know, our pride makes us think that we're right about everything. And this kind of crazy codependence we get into makes us think that my spouse has complete control over my happiness in my life. Well, that's not real either. That's not realistic, you know. So it's really complete obedience to the first commandment, which is, I am the Lord your God. You are not. Your husband is not. Stop it. You know, God has been trying to tell us this for, 5,000 years since Moses came down with that? You know, to just get the point that we assign ourselves and other people and the world around us far more power than it really has. So that to me, that's what humility is all about.
Yeah, that's a great definition of humility. And you know, by going to confession every single week, that there's this tremendous gift, the spiritual gift, among others, that comes out of the sacrament of penance. And that's what understanding what true humility is all about. And that gives you such an incredible bedrock of strength. Dr. Jennifer Roback-Morse has written a book, 101 Tips for a Happier Marriage. She's given you some great tips this morning. You can get your copy. Go up on our Morning Air Facebook page. The link to that is there. And also, Dr. Morse is starting down in the Diocese of Lake Charles, Louisiana, a Go to Confession campaign. Why not do that? There's an interesting Lenten goal if you're looking for one on this Ash Wednesday for you and your spouse to go to confession once a week, every other week between Ash Wednesday and Easter, and look at the transformation in your marriage that will take place through that beautiful sacrament of penance. Dr. Jennifer Roback-Morse from the Ruth Institute, online at ruthinstitute.org. Thank you, Dr. Jennifer. God bless you.
You've just been listening to Dr. J and John Harper discussing 101 Tips for a Happier Marriage, one of the books Dr. J has authored with Betsy Karagas. They also touch on the Ruth Institute's Go to Confession campaign, running during Lent in Lake Charles, Louisiana, on Relevant Radio's Morning Air. The Ruth Institute is a nonprofit educational organization equipping effective advocates for family stability and love, both at home and in the public square. Our podcasts can be found online at ruthinstitute.org and iTunes. And as always, they're under a Creative Commons license. If you've enjoyed them, please share them with friends. Like us on Facebook, check out the site, and subscribe to our weekly newsletter to stay informed.